So every Monday, you are going to continue with our business edition of Mind Your What?
Business.
Mind Your Business. Part what now? Part 20. Part 20. And I'm going to be talking about the good place. The good what? The good place. God will take you to your own good place.
Amen.
In the book of Genesis chapter 42, 1 and 2. Genesis 42, 1 and 2. Okay, it has been in the story. Now, when Jacob saw that there was corn in Egypt, Jacob said unto his sons, why do ye look one upon another? And he said, behold, I have heard that there is corn in Egypt. Get you down thither and buy for us from thence, that we may live and not die. You will live and you will not die.
Amen.
The good place. You know, I think some years ago, a few years ago, I heard through the news media that, I think it was Canada, that Canada was celebrating the 50th year of uninterrupted power supply. I don't know whether you heard that. 50th year, some years ago, not this year. That for 50 years, that is electricity. I said, what? You mean somebody 50 years, they have not heard, hey, I've never. Before, I'm just teasing. That 50th year uninterrupted power supply. They will not understand what some people may be going through. But that being as what it is, you know, in that kind of place, there are some businesses that will not do well. Even in that kind of place, for example, the production and the sales of generating sets, what we call generator, will not do well there. That is, the generating set is a good product, but that is a bad place for that kind of product. In life, in business, that is also true. There are some things that will not do well in some certain places. And that is one sense that you must have in business. The location. The product may be good. The seed may be good. But the ground is also important. That happened to be the wisdom of the parable that Jesus Christ was giving in the book of Mark chapter 4 verse 7. Mark 4. It said that a good seed was taken by a farmer. But the good seed fell on some particular ground and it did not bring forth good productivity. It did not bring forth great money. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. And I would have even thought that, okay, to bring, at least when you invest money into something, to bring little may not bring. He yielded no fruit. I pray that God will take your own, whether good or service, to the right place for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Even Jesus Christ, there are some places he did not do well. Jesus can happen to be the best product that the world has ever received. Yes, he did not do well in some places. There are some places that he did well because they were expectant of his power, of his anointing. And immediately he got there, he just started manifesting and they appreciated him. In the book of Matthew chapter 8, 16. They were expectant of his presence and his power. Immediately he came like this. He just started manifesting. And when the evening was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils. And he cast out the spirit with his word and healed how many of them?
Oh.
He healed all. They were sick. Imagine, I could just imagine the crusade. Maybe there were about 3,000 people. And then if you are sick, just come. Maybe 1,005 just came with different kind of things. And he healed all. But in another place, the Bible said that he could not do mighty works. There is a good place for whatever that thing that you are doing is. God will take you to the right place.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the book of Mark chapter 6, 5 and 6, Mark chapter 6, 5 and 6. In a particular place, the Bible said that Jesus Christ could not do much. You know what I mean? Has he changed? Has his power reduced? No. Has he stopped doing something? No. But there is a place that is always best for a particular product. And he could dare do no mighty work. See that he laid his hand upon a few sick folk and he healed them. And the man, he too was surprised that is it not the same me? And he marveled because of the unbelief. And he went round about the villages. He just said, well, let me just be doing the few things. Let me just be teaching. The good place, very well. You know, there are some football players, very skillful. But in their own land, you notice that they never made any good headway. Yet very skillful. But through one thing or the other, some of them have moved to the foreign land, some particular places, the same skill, they will start getting appreciation from different people there. And before you know it, they are made. Just because they just go to the right place. And by the time they now come back to that place that they did not appreciate in their own land, they become philanthropists. And the people that were not even looking at them, they start singing their praises. And prophesying into your own life that God will take you to your own good place. Yeah. I said, God will take you to your own good place. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. See that? That's why sometimes Jesus Christ, you'll be forcing him to speak. He will not speak. He said, and he has so many things to speak. He realized that what he had already told his disciples, he said, what's our seeds? That if I speak here, it will not make any impact. Let me just keep quiet. That's that time that they arrested him, they wanted to crucify him. They're saying so many things that, oh yeah, defend yourself. He knew that one defense, he knew that it will not work. So he did not bother to even say anything. As much as we want to defend yourself, now talk. Mark chapter 15, 3 to 5. Mark chapter, Pilate was amazed that, say something. He said that, if I throw my seed upon this thorny ground, it will not, I don't like wasting my efforts. And the chief priest accused him of many things, but he answered nothing. And Pilate asked him again, saying, answerest thou nothing? Behold, how many things they witness against thee? And Jesus yet answered nothing. So that who? There are some times when some people are speaking. You know that you don't have what to say. But sometimes when you speak too much in the presence of a fool, you weary yourself. So sometimes you have to qualify the ground that you are going to throw your seed. And there are some places that when you speak, what you are saying will be very much appreciated. It's very important that even in business, the same thing applies. In that story that we read, Jacob was telling his children, this place, we have heard that there is corn in Egypt. Go there. That place is actually prospering. It's good for you. Canada, very good place. But the sale of generator, very bad place. There is a particular place that is good for you. The same way, I'm not saying that you are going to be very much improved than you are. No, the way you are. Once you just get to that place, everything will just turn around. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, take me to the good place for me. In the name of Jesus, the same way you are, the same way you are, you will just see that everything will just turn around for you. You will just be much appreciated. Take me to that good place for me. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. When somebody is in a place that is not the best place or the good place for, the person does so much work, yet little effort, little productivity. There are some people that are working in some places, they are putting in so much, And some of their counterparts or colleagues somewhere, they are putting half of what they are putting, and they are getting 100 times. I'm not saying 10 times. I know what I'm saying. I'm a pastor and I deal with different people. 100 times what those ones are getting. And they are in the same profession. Yet those ones are putting less. It's just about the place. In the book of Hebrews chapter 11, 36 to 38. Hebrews 11 as I close, 36 to 38. You know that Hebrews chapter 11 talks about the heroes of faith. But they not talked about some people that, wow, awesome qualities. They said, but the world is not worthy of them. Meaning that their awesome qualities happen to be so much that yet where they are located, some of them they kill them, some of them they mock them, some of them, but the heaven is realizing that these people are caught, that the world is not worthy. There are some people where they are. That place and the people there, they are not worthy. They cannot really see that these are great people that we should appreciate. And others are trial of cruel mockings and scourging. Yeah, moreover, of bond and imprisonment. They were stoned. They were sawn asunder. Were tempted. Were slain with the sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented. Of whom what?
The
world was not worthy. He said that these people, they are God's gift to them. That's why Jesus Christ was telling them one time, he said that the prophet that God is sending to you, you are killing them. He said that until you say, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. That can God be sending people to come and help you, but you are not really seeing them. Oh, open your mouth and pray and say, Father, let the right people. Open your mouth and say, let the right people in my life. See me for who I am. In the name of Jesus Christ. When they see you for who you are, they will address you aright. They will appreciate you aright. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. As an architect, I have done a few architectural designs. But in my experience, I have done some works for some people. Maybe we design mansion for them of about 20-something rooms inside. And the appreciation was maybe just okay. I tell some people that I just need to do a duplex of how many rooms? Maybe about 4 rooms and suits. We so. And what those people offered me happened to be 10 times what I did more work for. That is the good place for me. All of you. Happened to be a good place for me. You will do a little and say, wow, what a... And another place you can do so much. And say, you see, and the story. Tell yourself, no more story in my life. But glory henceforth. Rise to your feet and pray and say, Father, take me to the good place for me. In the name of Jesus, take me to that good place for me. Take me to that good place. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Everlasting Father, just like you also showed us through the scripture concerning you, and you gave us instances of 2 places that you operated. One, you were very much appreciated, and you expressed yourself in awesome way. Another place, still yourself, but it was like a struggle. Lord, take every one of us, we that are here and the people connected to us via the internet, to the right places for us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So that which we have to offer in good, in services, will be very much appreciated.
Amen.
And the reward will be so awesome.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.